Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today's matchup features a couple of big targets who will be looking to get open in the middle of the field. It's the Jaguars going up against the Seahawks. Now we'll take you out to Everbank Field for this matchup.
Seahawks, Jaguars coming up on EA Sports as we come to you from Jacksonville, Florida for today's game.
Hello, friends. Jim Nantz along with Bill Sims. And, Bill, it's an absolutely gorgeous day here for football. And how will that factor into this game?
We're going to see a game that's all out. I think the coaches, they prepared all week. They devised these big game plans, and the weather's good. Now they can call any play they want on that play sheet because the elements are not going to play a factor. So it's going to be exciting.
The Jaguars are back deep, ready to return the kickoff. Steven Hauschka ready to kick it away to start today's game. This game has officially begun. Runs up to grab it at the four. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line.
So the rookie quarterback will take the field, trying to improve week by week.
Well, he's getting some experience. It's not a lot, but it's enough to help him feel more comfortable and I think play better. He should do well here today.
The Jaguars take it from the 28. And that's the type of run I think this offense would take all game long, Phil.
Oh, would they ever? They would love this. This is showing your dominance here. The offensive line doing a good job, but also solid job by the running back picking up some good yards.
Lewis, usually a tight end, but he's in the backfield this time. The Jaguars snap it at the 36. There's a flag out.
Holding offense.
The defense accepts the penalty.
Still second down.
After the penalty, it's second down and 12.
Get ready.
Quick drop back, throws the pass. And he's going to be tackled right around the 37.
Well, he's got talent. This receiver can make the catches when you throw it his way. And I think his talent, the way offenses are designed and the rules of the NFL, it makes guys like him almost unstoppable.
It'll be third down.
Let's go.
Takes it from the strong eye. And picks up about three.
That time, nice job. Offensive line gives him a little hole, and he gets in there and shows his toughness and picks up the first down.
Lewis is a tight end, but lined up in the backfield for this play. It's complete to Allen Robinson. And now we'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
Well, I think early in the game, anytime you cross the 50-yard line, it just gives you confidence that what you're doing is going to work today. Let's see if they can take advantage of that and take it on down into the end zone.
First down here after the completion. The give. Got the first, and he's got some space.
You're running back in this league, and you pick up first downs, and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
First down here after the run. The Jaguars come out in the pistol. On the money. Game's 20.
Well, the quarterback has such great confidence in the receiver. And why not? He's talented. And every time the football's thrown his way, he finds a way to make the catch.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive. That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. Robinson's got it. Screen play. Irvin's all over the ball carrier.
Well, we see it more and more. Football's thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
That's second down coming up. Dropping back 3. The defense gets a sack.
How about the defense on that play? They were not fooled. They see the pass coming. They get the penetration. They get to the quarterback quick. And that's a big sack down near the goal line.
Loss of 5 on the play. Coming to the line at the 15. Third and forever. And it's caught by Allen Burns.
Well, it's third and long. Protect against the long pass. Make the quarterback throw it short. And then just come up there and make the tackle.
And he converts here on the field goal try. They put up 3 here in the first to take the lead.
It's always good to get those points on the board. The lead and get the other team chasing you.
That's a touchback. The ball will be spotted at the 20. Wilson's, of course, going to be the man at quarterback today.
Russell Wilson is absolutely maybe the most mobile quarterback in the NFL. Hard to get a big hit on him, and if there's pressure in the pocket, he will get outside and make a play.
Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield. Lynch is tackled down after a gain of 12.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
The Seahawks from the 32. Toss to the outside. They are in the backfield in a hurry and will bring him down for a loss behind the line of scrimmage.
The Jaguars defensive coordinator, my gosh, he is one happy guy. Anytime you get in the backfield and stop the runner and make him lose yards, that's some good stuff.
Second and 12. He'll throw it over the middle. Baldwin tackled down.
Well, that basic slant route, Jim, it is thrown and caught. It doesn't get a first down, but it was really well executed. The offensive line gave the quarterback time and sight lines so he could put the football on target.
Offense still looking for a first after that completion on second down. The Jaguars defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Easy catch there. No one near him. He's in the clear. The 10, touchdown. Bill, that's a terrific touchdown here late in the first, and they've now taken the lead.
Shoot, touchdowns are terrific no matter what time you get them, though, Jim. But, hey, late in the first, what a way to answer for that offense. That was a really, really sharp drive.
The Seahawks now lined up for the extra point. Makes the PAT. The Jaguars return team is in position. Perhaps they can run one out pretty. Deep and shift the momentum. The scores 7-3. He's not going to test the coverage this time. It'll come out to the 20. The Jaguars back onto the field now to get another drive started. They came away with a field goal in their last possession, Phil, but had to be a letdown because they were really moving the football.
Oh, I think you're right. They had to be let down. You execute so many good plays going down the field, and you just need that one to get you in the end zone. They did not do that. So, Jim, I think you're right. I think they were a little down about that field goal.
The offensive lineup includes tight end Julius Thomas, a former college basketball player at Portland State.
Yeah, how about that transition? He plays 1 year of football at Portland State, becomes a fourth-round draft pick, and then he just has an outstanding year in 2013. He is a terrific athlete. The Jaguars do a really good job this time on offense. The quarterback throws the ball short. They pick up a few yards, and now it makes third down much easier.
Third down on the way. The Jaguars line up in the pistol. And after only three plays, that incompletion brings us to fourth down. That was very short work for the offense as the defense. Up and makes another nice go of it, forcing a punting situation.
Really good job by the defense. I like what they're doing out there. They're showing imagination and hustle. On the offensive side, that was terrible. They got to come up with a better plan than we've seen so far here early in this game.
The Seahawks offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
And Marshawn Lynch with the grab. And that's a gain of maybe 5. Marshawn Lynch found a second win for his career when he came out to Seattle.
He did find a second win, no doubt about it, Jim Nance. And I'll tell you, he got bigger, stronger, and he's as tough as I've ever seen him. He is a perfect fit for the Seahawks.
Second down and 5. Lynch now slashing to the right side, looking for room. One quarter complete, and defense has been the story thus far. Back after this.
Papa John's, the official pizza sponsor of the NFL.
Here we are about to start the second quarter, and both offenses still seem to be trying to figure out a game plan for this one, Phil.
The heck with figuring out things. It's time to open it up a little bit. You got to take some chances to make positive plays in this league. These are good defenses, so if you want to get some productive plays on the offensive side, take a chance and go down the field with the football. Lynch is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9. Wilson's a tight end, but now shifted into the backfield. Airing it out. With the contact, the ball comes out.
Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it, he has a chance of going all the way.
Now, looking at third down. From the gun, Russell Wilson, ready for the snap. From the gun. On the money. He going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
I think as time has gone on, more and more coaches and teams, we see them going for it on fourth and short. But this decision, you're winning the game, fourth and short, you're near me. Field, I don't think you go for it. Don't let the pressure of the fans or your players get into your mind. Punt the football away. That's the right decision.
Coverage team won't get a chance this time as it bounces into the end zone. The Jaguars gearing up for their next drive now as defense has become the order of the day here. These teams trading punts on the previous two possessions.
Yeah, when you're playing in a game like this as a quarterback, you know the defenses are hot and the one you're playing against is tough. So you got to be careful, be very smart in your decision making. Don't take any chances in a situation like this.
Gets about 9 on the play.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Get ready. Second and short. They'll run it here. He's brought down at the 30-yard line. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
Lewis is playing out of position in the backfield here. Handoff made. That's Wagner making the stop.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
The Jaguar snap it at the 36. Going for the home run. Pulls it in.
Nice throw down the field. Big game by the offense. Nothing like big passing plays. And the quarterback put it right on the money.
The defense at this point trying to keep him out of the end zone. Let's see how they back up the big play here.
Get ready.
They'll go ground. Not able to get away from Chancellor.
The Jaguars have really been dominant today on the offensive side. In the red zone now, they just take the football and they run it right at the defense and pick up solid yards.
They'll try over again on second down. The Seahawks defense now is going to go nickel. Allen Burns with the grab. They're just grinding away down here, inching closer to the end zone.
Well, that's what you got to do sometimes. It's hard always to think that you're going to come out and just make big plays. You got to do the dirty work, and this offense is doing it right now.
The defense loading up on the line, getting set for this snap. Takes it across. It is a touchdown. And we're halfway through the second quarter. And with the touchdown trip, they are now in front in this ball game.
And this game's flying along. We've seen some good play in it. But that drive right there was not a good job by the defensive front. They were all over the place and allowed the offense to execute some plays and take the lead.
The Jaguars now going for the point after. Oh, he actually misses the point after. The Seahawks. Are set to return the kickoff. tackle just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. This offense would love to get some points on the board right now, and it would help if their top receiving threat also made his presence felt for the first time today.
Yeah, it sure would, wouldn't it? You know, that's what you need. You need energy from your star wide receiver. They need to make a catch, break a tackle, get some yards, and get everybody excited about the play. If they can get it to him, maybe he can make that play to get this offense going.
Lynch is a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
First and 10. He's got the catch. That's a gain of 10.
That's what you call a bullet pass. Very little space to throw the football into, but he gets it done. A lot of velocity right on target.
First down at the 46. Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch.
Lynch is a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
Jackson is in the backfield. It's Jermaine Kearse coming down with it. Paul Posluszny makes the tackle.
That's a good job by the receiver running the drag route across the field. These are not easy throws for the quarterback, but he sticks it right on him for the completion.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. Helfitt with the catch. And he's taken down, but not until he picks up the first. Halftime, 2 minutes away. All right, so now as we go back to the field, we've got a good game going, and an offense is trying to close the gap before halftime. First down and 10. Lynch has got it on the handle. Smith's there to make the stop.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short game.
From just inside the 30. Lynch is in the backfield. Second down and 6. And they're all over it for the sack.
Not a good job by the quarterback that time. Inside of 2 minutes in the first half, you got to get rid of the football. Nobody's open. Just throw it away. That time, he loses yards by taking the sack.
After getting to the quarterback, again, it'll be third down and 12. Third and 12. Had it for just a second, but then it came out on contact.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
Hauschka set to attempt the field goal. The kick, and it's through there. The kick is good. And taking the lead just before the half will definitely have them feeling a little more positive as they head into the break.
Oh, yeah, it gives you a little pep in your step, no question about it. Nothing like leading at halftime, knowing that all the work you did during the week has got you in a... frame of mind right now.
S- smartly takes a knee in the end zone. The Seahawks defense comes back onto the field. Did not look so good that last series, giving up the touchdown.
Oh, you know the coaches are upset. My gosh, they ran some of the most elementary defenses that you can run, and they had mistakes by the defensive players. So they coached them up on the sidelines. We'll see if we see different results.
Connects with Thomas. That's his first reception today.
Good job that time by the ball carrier, picking up what he can, and he is very smart. Gets out of bounds to stop the clock.
So they complete one, and still it's second down. The Jaguars lined up. Everybody split out wide. Out of the shotgun formation. Looking to go deep. And a flag is down.
Holding offense.
That penalty is, of course, going to be accepted by the defense. After the penalty, it's second down and 12. The Seahawks with a nickel look here on defense. Takes it from the gun. Makes the catch in the open field.
Nice job that time by the runner. Gets out of bounds after the play. You got under 2 minutes, and you need to stop the clock, so he gets it done.
This play set up by the long gainer. They'll go ground. And that's good for only a yard or two. The Jaguars are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here. That timeout might be very useful for the offense. They're now ready to go. Second down here.
Well, let's go. Right 38.
And it's caught by Evan Burns. A timeout charge to the offense. This next play comes from the 30. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. And incomplete. What a hit that time.
That was a big hit by the defender that time. The receiver drops the football. I'll tell you what, I guarantee the next time he goes over the middle, he'll be looking for that defender.
This will be second down. Taken down. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down. The Jaguars with no timeouts left. Offense ready for action coming out of their timeout. And Myers is lining up for the field goal. He's one for one so far today. The kick is good. It's a field goal just before the intermission to move them in front.
When you make a field goal late in the second quarter, Jim, it just eases the tension of your football team, of the coaches, and even the fans are happy sometimes when you take a lead late in the second quarter. Yeah.
The 20 and brought down at the 24. Russell Wilson retaking the field. It hasn't quite been the start he was hoping for, but he's actually played quite well so far, Phil.
Yeah, he's played well. He's executed every time he's given a chance to make a play. Jim, he has done it. You got to look at this game so far and say, hey, the defense has got to step up if they hope to win this game today.
They go screen with Lynch. We're headed to the half here in a tight, low-scoring defensive battle. I'm sure both teams will be making adjustments offensively coming out of the half. Larry Ridley's coming up next.
Thanks, Jim, and welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. Both teams have played smart with the football in the first half. Each team has avoided that one big turnover to this point, and it's a reason we have a very tight game at halftime. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Down to late in the first. The quick pass, it's complete. And after the short pass, he'll score. They're now on top by four. Jaguars take it early in the second. The pass will be completed into coverage, and he'll end up picking up 53 yards on the play. Jaguars still on the field. He'll take the run up the middle, and he caps off the six-play drive with a score. That takes the lead up to two. Jaguars with the ball late in the half. Broken coverage here on the pass play. He would pick up 8 yards and then duck out of bounds. So that's all for us at the EA Sports Studio. We'll go back now to the field for the start of the second half.
Jim Nance, Phil Sims. Everbank Field is our site today, and the third quarter is about to commence. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Jaguars defense heads onto the field here to start the second half, looking for another stop and once again to get the ball back to their offense as they're leading in this one here early third, Phil.
I like what they did in the first half. The defense goes in there at halftime to give a little rest, so come out here and show that energy and take advantage of the situation and make some plays. The Seahawks did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind in the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and, you know, you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
The Seahawks snap it at the 41. The Seahawks now move the chains. That's his first reception today. That is how you draw it up, isn't it, Phil?
Oh, man, a quarterback loves guys that can make catches like this, and they're just so strong. They know how to zero in. They never lose concentration, and you never see him drop a pass.
Wilson's completion percentage, 70% on the day. Thought I saw a little flinch right there, and it's going to push the offense back 5 yards.
False start, offense.
Coming to the line at the 50. First and 15. Wilson's got it on a pass, had some heat on it.
The Seahawks, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
First and 10. Lynch is brought down after picking up 6 on this play.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt. When you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Second down, 4 to go. Baldwin's got it. First down. The offense picks up another first down and extends this drive.
They are, Jim. They're marching down the field, and I give all the credit to the offensive line. They are dominating the defense right now.
The Jaguars lined up in the nickel. Now first and 10. Has the grab. And it's Paul Posluszny who makes the hit.
The Seahawks have been awesome today on first down. That time it's a nice play design. They throw the football, picks up solid yards. Second and short. Boy, that's what every offense likes to be in. When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
Paul Posluszny makes the tackle.
Lynch is trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
This is third down. The Jaguars with two extra defensive backs in the dime. Wilson from the shotgun. And it's caught by Curse.
The Seahawks just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
Wilson's completion percentage, 80% on the day. First and goal. Lynch. Brown's there that time for the tackle.
Lynch is never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
About to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. The Jaguars defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. He'll go nickel. Freddie Jackson with the reception.
Well, that last play almost got him in here. And when you look at this, what do they do? Well, you just want to punch it in. There's a lot of different scenarios. You could do a play-action fake, probably get somebody wide open, or have a running back just jump over the top for the touchdown.
Wilson's completed his last six passes. Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one. And he's in for the touchdown. And at just about the midway mark of the third quarter, they are out in front thanks to that touchdown.
When you score a touchdown somewhere in the mid-third quarter, what that does for your football team, you start thinking about ways that we can close the deal so we can find a way to get this game over with and still be in the lead. It's up to the defense. Be aggressive and make it happen.
Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch.
Hey, I like the play. Really creative thought process there, and the offense caught the defense by surprise.
Steven Hauschka. Ready for the kickoff. And no return this time as he takes a knee. The Jaguars back on the field with their offense now. They've scored on each of their last two drives and have to be feeling pretty confident right now at the start of this one.
Yeah, isn't it amazing what the mind can do sometimes on the football field? You go out there and you score, and you feel like nothing can stop you. So would not be surprised to see them go out there and have success again. Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, it can make a big play.
Second and 10. And now here's the handoff. He's brought down at the 20-yard line. Looking at the passing numbers on both sides of the ball, they're just not there. The coverage has been good, and it's been hard to move the ball against those secondaries.
Yeah, good job for the defense today. They got a good pass rush going. The coverage has been good down the field. And also, the defense has been good, but the quarterback has not been real sharp.
Third down now. The Jaguars come to the line with an empty backfield. He'll stand back beyond the center in the gun. Can't hold on here as it goes incomplete.
Robinson's not able to come up with the catch. And a lot of times when you see a receiver drop a pass, they... off it, that's one thing, or they're just trying to get it in their hands too quick. Why? Because they're trying to make some yards after the catch. That was the problem that time.
Fields it cleanly and starts his return. Gains 16. The Seahawks counted on the passing game early, but it slowed down after a hot start. Wilson's tried to adjust to the defense, but it hasn't worked out.
Well, he's tried, but listen, there's nothing he can do about the offensive line. It's not been as sharp, and I'll tell you what, when an offensive line is not sharp, our quarterback's going to lose confidence.
Lynch is going to secure the handoff, and that's a gain of 9. He's now over 80 yards rushing on the day.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to, and also it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Second and 1. They go screen with Lynch. And he's tackled down after picking up the first.
Good job by the offense picking up a first down there. They've been terrific all day long. They're winning the football game, and they are tiring this defense out.
Wilson's completion percentage, 80% on the day. Lynch lined up as the single back. Wilson with the give. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day. Leads us to second down. They bring in the extra tight end. Lynch is taking the handoff. He is tackled at the 40-yard line.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job on the offensive line.
Third down and 3. Looking across the middle. Gets about 4 yards that time.
The Seahawks offense has been tough today. They are fighting out there on the field. That's a nice job picking up that first down. It's been fun to watch. They got a small lead here in the second half. We'll see if that first down can lead them to a score.
First and 10. Here's the give to Fred Jackson. And gains maybe 4.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
So 3 quarters in the books, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Seahawks will come to the line trying to put together a scoring drive here in the fourth. Second down here after that run play. An extra tight end on the field for this one. Final quarter underway now with this snap. Lynch is tackled down at the 31.
Arm strength is a nice thing to have when the window of opportunity is very small. Quarterbacks with strong arms can still fire it in there. Nice throw right on target by the QB.
Third and 4 coming up following that completion. The Seahawks line up, split backfield. They'll go shotgun here. Throws the pass. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. That's reception number 4 for him.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion. The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
First down and 10. Lynch is tackled down after a gain of 5. As we've seen today, this is a team that's dedicated to the run, and it's paid off with some very good stats on the ground.
Well, it shows you what the coach thinks. He believes in running the football, and when you believe in it, what happens to your football team? They become tough, and they have shown that toughness here today. That's why they have such a good ground game going.
Look at that concentration as he makes the grab.
First First down by the offense in the red zone. And, you know, if you're on the defensive side, you don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive and take some chances.
Play after play after play here on this drive.
First and goal.
Hit power surge. Touchdown. That touchdown may have given them all the points they need to put this game away, partner.
Well, they've controlled it almost from start to finish, Jim, so that drive was impressive. Now let's see if their defense can just finish it off. If I had to guess, I like their chances. Tension, more decision making, the second guess in the NFL, and now they're going to have it. This 2-point conversion, more teams are going to do it because they don't want to kick the extra point from the 15-yard line.
The Jag. They're ready to return the kick. No return here as he takes a knee in the end zone. The Jaguars weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt as they take the field here. Do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of the information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three and out business.
Well, that's a bad business to be in. I know, I get in a lot of bad businesses. You can only take what the defense gives you. Even though the offense is down here in the fourth quarter, they throw it short. That was a smart play.
It's second down and three.
Gets it out for the completion. He's tackled, but not until he picked up the first down.
When you're behind in a football game, all you can do on the offensive side is just go out there and thinking about making plays and picking up first downs. Good job by the offense.
The Jaguars take it from the 33, and it's incomplete. Just can't hold on that time.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
Second and 10 coming up. The Jaguars take it from the 33. Knocked down as he fires it.
Tough situation you found yourself in. Third and long, you're losing the football game. There are not many plays here that are going to pick up the first down. So be careful here. Don't be too aggressive. If you're too aggressive, you will make a mistake.
From the gun. Pulls it in.
He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Nice job that time by the defense. Knowing the situation, go ahead and let the quarterback complete the pass. Just make sure you come up and make the tackle before the first down. Good job. Fourth down coming up.
The Jaguars come to the line of scrimmage and empty out the backfield. Everyone split out wide. Allen Robinson. Has the reception.
The Jaguars go for it on fourth down and they do not get it done. Now it's up to their defense to bail them out.
They're happy to begin this drive from this point.
The Seahawks offense looks unstoppable. Touchdown drives the last two times they've had it. And here they go again, Phil.
Yeah, they've been very good, Jim. They're taking advantage of situations and scoring touchdowns. And we know that's what you must do. If you don't get these touchdowns, what happens later in the game always comes back to bite you.
The Seahawks are in front thanks to their quarterback.
Wilson's been unstoppable so far.
He has been unstoppable, hasn't he? When your quarterback is hot, keep giving the football to him. They've done it, and he has rewarded the coaches.
Lynch looking for a lane. He's now past the 100-yard mark on the day.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to, and also it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield. He'll throw it over the middle. Incomplete as he was looking short. Third and five coming up. The Seahawks will line up. First down markers right at the 15-yard line. Jackson out to the right. Lining up for a 35-yard field goal. Drives it through for the field goal. Midway through the fourth, and that field goal almost makes this game look like it's over. I know it's not, Phil, but that's a huge three.
Well, in a time like this, when you have a lead midway. In the fourth quarter, you got to understand the situations no matter who's on the field. So if you're on defense, what's your number one thought? Don't give up a big play. That's the only way you can lose.
Robinson's going to take a knee, so this will come out to the 20. The Jaguars take the field here. Their last possession ended with a very crazy decision going for it on fourth down from their own territory. An unusual decision, to say the least.
I don't know if it's unusual. We see this all the time from this guy. So it's when you're going to learn. You know, I guess when you pile up enough losses, you'll finally say, hey, I want to win a game. I'm going to manage it differently. And in those situations, you should punt.
Okay, if you were playing the game right now, what would you have done with that last possession?
I absolutely would have punted it without question.
Get ready.
He'll take the snap from the gun. Allen Robinson with the catch.
My gosh, the wide receivers in the NFL now, it's incredible. It's not that you have one. Every team has two and three, and some have four. Good job that time by him hauling in that pass.
Get ready.
First and 10. The catch is made. Not able to get away from Chancellor. Taking another look at the stats here, we have a wide receiver who has put together a complete game, Phil.
It has been a tremendous game, Jim, no doubt about it. Now we understand why guys want to be wide receivers in the NFL instead of running backs. So many more ways to get the plays happen once you get it.
Back now in this one, and time is running out here in the fourth quarter. After the pass play, gain 7. Second and 3 on the way.
Let's go.
Out of the shotgun. Allen Hurns with the grab.
Corner routes not thrown enough in this league anymore. A lot of teams don't do it because it takes a strong arm quarterback to get it done. That was a terrific throw up the field that time.
Has Thomas. Picks up about 5. That's another reception, giving him 2. Timeout won't be used here. They'll go to the hurry.
Get ready.
The Seahawks defense now is going to go nickel. They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun. Julius Thomas gets his hands on it. That's a pickup of 14. The Jaguars are going to burn the first of their 3 timeouts right here. We're back, and the offense is ready to roll after the timeout.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
It's complete to Allen Robinson.
After that grab, it's now second down and two.
The Jaguars will go with the pistol on this play.
Touchdown as we near the end of this one.
What a throw by the quarterback for a touchdown. It was just really nice. He threw it beautifully, right on target. Touchdown.
The Jaguars now going for the point after. It's good. The Seahawks will get the ball back now. They just need to be smart. Still up here late in the fourth. Scores 29-19. The Jaguars lined up. Onside kick coming up. Everything hinged. Covering that onside kick, and they failed to do so.
Well, Jim, when you're doing the onside kick, you really got to hope for that perfect bounce of the football. That time it did not happen. That's why they didn't recover.
The Seahawks offense doesn't want to do anything to screw this one up at this point, Phil. They've got the lead, and they've got the football late in the game.
Wow, you're such a positive guy, Jim. I like that comment. Go down there and tell them that. Don't screw it up. But what do you do in a situation like this? I always like to try to draw the defense off sides on first down because they're anxious and you can take advantage of that.
Second and five coming up. The Seahawks have it at the 39. Not able to get away from Odrick that time. The Jaguars have to take their final timeout. That's it. The defense needed to slow this game down. That timeout might be very useful. Now they're ready to go. After that last carry, it's third and three. The Seahawks have to get to the 33 for a first. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down. He's got over 110 yards rushing on the day.
Well, we know you can win the game, but just running the football, then you just run the football. Take no chances. Keep two hands around it at all times, and don't worry about the extra yard.
Takes the knee. This was a tough loss to handle.
Yeah, it was. So much confidence coming into the game, thinking you had the game plan, your team was healthy, nothing can go wrong, and then it does. You make the mistakes and you lose. Tough to take.
Phil Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.